Good morning. Yeah, on Wednesday, 21st week in ordinary time.
My soul is longing for your peace, near to you, my God.
Jesus, you came to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy. Jesus, you come in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy. Jesus, you will come again in glory with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy. Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, who show the light of your truth to those who go astray, so that they may return to the right path, give all who for the faith they profess are accounted Christians the grace to reject whatever is contrary to the name of Christ, and to strive after all that does it honor. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. We instruct you, brothers and sisters, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, to shun any brother who walks in a disorderly way and not according to the tradition they received from us. For you know how one must imitate us, for we did not act in a disorderly way among you, nor did we eat food received free from anyone. On the contrary, in toil and drudgery, night and day we worked, so as not to burden any of you. Not that we do not have that right. Rather, we wanted to present ourselves as a model for you, so that we might imitate us. In fact, when we were with you, we instructed you that if anyone was unwilling to work, neither should that one eat. May the Lord of peace himself give you peace at all times and in every way. The Lord be with all of you. This greeting is in my own hand, Paul's. This is the sign in every letter. This is how I write. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with all of you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed are those who fear the Lord.
Blessed are those who fear the Lord.
Blessed are you who fear the Lord, who walks in his ways. For you shall eat the fruit of your handiwork. Blessed shall you be and favored.
Blessed are those who fear the Lord.
Behold, thus is the man blessed who fears the Lord. The Lord blesses you from Zion. May you see the prosperity of Jerusalem all the days of your life.
Blessed are those who fear the Lord.
Thank you.
Very early on in our lives, we are often taught by our parents quickly and reinforced by our teachers in school that we should not call other people's names, that we should not label people, that we should treat each and everyone equal in the sight of God. But today the Lord really comes down on the scribes and the Pharisees. Tucked in with the midst of the Pharisees is St. Paul himself. You hypocrites. But the Lord challenges them, as he challenges us today, to make sure that our words and our actions match together. That what we say, we do. And what we do, we say. Well, yes, unfortunately, we can only judge the outside. We don't have the ability to look into the inside of another person, but the Lord himself does. He can see the motivation behind what we do and how we act. It is a tough cause. It is a high bar. It is a challenge in each and every moment. But yet within our lives, we have been called the ultimate of the names. We have been called a Christian. May we live, work, and act like the Lord Jesus. May we do it through, with, and in his holy name. And may we always be willing to make sure that our words and actions, like good students, like good learners, like good children of God, always match together. Unfortunately, they don't. We are sinful. We have been plagued by original sin, and we fail. But we come back to the divine mercy of God. We come back to the Eucharist, back to reconciliation that flows from the throne of God. May we be willing to forgive, may we be understanding, but above all, may we always treasure and keep sacred the very gift of human life. God bless, be safe. Trusting in the Lord of peace to meet out all our needs, let us bring our petitions before him. For the church, may God grant within her people a purity of heart and a genuine witness of his love. We pray to the Lord. For all positions of governmental and civic leadership, may Christ inspire them in modeling self-sacrifice. We pray to the Lord. For those who suffer, may the Lord sustain them through his loving presence and the generosity of his people. We pray to the Lord. For this community of faith, may God look favorably and generously upon the work of our hands, that it may be for his glory. We pray to the Lord. Vocations to the priesthood and the religious life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
the safety and security of all of our military personnel serving throughout the world, and for all those who battle the coronavirus and indeed serve us, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
all who have died, may they rejoice in the gift of everlasting life, as today we in particular remember the soul of Martha Rotson. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
loving Father, we thank you for hearing our prayers and ask that you answer them according to your holy will, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." the mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Alfred, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant Martha, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who is united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, in Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Let the Savior's come at, and for by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, and thy kingdom come, and thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. us pray. Having consumed these gifts, we pray, O Lord, that by our participation in this mystery, its saving effects may grow upon us through Christ our Lord. I'd like to express my gratitude to all of you, not only here present, but those who joined us virtually yesterday for any part of that intense day of prayer, beginning with Mass in the morning, adoration throughout the day, and then the closing holy hour last evening. It was just amazing and overwhelming that no matter when I walked into the church, and I came over almost every single hour to check in and to be part of that prayer experience, there was at least 6, 8, 9 people here present before the Blessed Sacrament, a compliment to the parish and to the people, but really a sign of our prayer and our pleading before the Lord for his intercession and all that is happening within our lives. Just about 50 people who gathered last evening and well over 100 who joined online virtually for the holy hour in the evening. So I am most grateful to everyone questioned throughout the day and especially after last night is, can we do this again? We will plan another time as we journey into the fall to come before the Lord in adoration and also to spend some time in holy hour. Throughout the last, maybe next time, instead of doing it here in the church, we can do it outside, and we can do it underneath the gift of creation, especially if it's a nice day and the leaves are changing and the fall is settling in. It would be a beautiful atmosphere. So the kind of things that will tuck away. And of course, Mary Ellen was fully what we'd be planning over the next couple of weeks. A few extra prayers for her as she gets ready to get prepped up and going and also go through the audit of the compliance of the charter initiatives of the Charter of Dallas and part of the Conference of Catholic Bishops. So all that's coming up within the next 3 weeks. So any extra prayer, I know she will be very more than grateful for. Do have a pleasant day. Be safe. The Lord be with you. The mighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your name.